Let us move on to the new topic, which is rectification of errors. It is a very interesting topic. You could have understand the concept carefully. Already we have seen that the accounting cycle, isn't it? What is the accounting cycle? From the transaction, we are preparing the journal entry. From that, we are preparing the ledger. And then we are going to prepare the trial balance. So, in the trial balance stage itself, if there is already, we can recollect the trial balance. If there is any difference in the trial balance, where we have transferred the suspense account. If there is any difference in the debit side, we can write the difference, suspense account and debit side. If there is any difference in the credit side, so you can write the suspense account in the credit side. So, like that, we have tallied the trial balance. For the time being, we are doing that. So, after that, we are going to locate the error. Where is the error we have committed? In that stage, we call it as a rectification of errors. After rectifying all the errors, we should ensure whether all the errors are rectified. Then only we can prepare the trading and profit and loss account. Why we are preparing the trading and profit and loss account? To know the financial position of the concern. So, trading and profit and loss account we can prepare. Then only we can know the correct gross profit. Then we can prepare based on the trading and profit and loss account. We can prepare profit and loss account. Then we can prepare the balance sheet. This is a final statement. So this is a final statement. From this balance sheet we can know the true and fair view of the business concern. If there is a errors are not rectified, we cannot know the correct position of the balance, correct position of the concern. So this is how this stage after the trial balance, between the final accounts, the error should be rectified. Then only we can get the correct profit. If we know the correct profit, then only we can survive, we can do the business further. Whether we can withstand in the business or we don't want to wind up the business, this is the stage of finalization stage. So that we are doing this rectification, the error rectification. We should locate the error and rectify the error. So let us dwell deeper into the concept. Rectification of errors. What is the main purpose of the business? To know the profit. So how can we know the accuracy? Accuracy of the business, accuracy of the accounts without any errors. The perfect, everything is perfect. All the debits are in debit side, all the credits are in credit side, all the postings are proper. So each and every stage we have done, all the postings are in a prescribed accounting procedure. So the error should be identified, and if there is any error is committed, we must locate the error, identify the error, and we should rectify the error. Nowadays, on those days, all the accounts are manual accounting. See, accountant also human being. He is also subject to worries, tension, everything. Because of that tension, all the tension will reflect in his work only, isn't it? So, it is as he can do any error. Nowadays, everything is computerized. So, error, even though it is a computerized accounting, there is a possibility of error in the accounts. So, we should find out the error, and then only we can know the real profit of the business. See here, all the credits are more, all the debits are less. Where which expenses we did not incur, whatever the expenses we have incurred, but we never forgot to enter into the expense side. So debit all expenses, isn't it? It reflects the trial balance. Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. We have credited incomes and gains alone, we forgot to debit the debt, all the expenses. So that the account is not tallied. See here, what is the very purpose of the accounts? See, very purpose of maintaining the accounting record is to know the profit made on the, whether we are doing the business in profit or if we are going to incur loss. So, by the business entity and its financial position at every end of the accounting year. So how can we measure the accuracy? Accuracy is measured, is assured only when there is no error in the books of accounts. Without error in the books of accounts, the people will relay, all the auditors will accept and they will put sign in the accounts. Then, to ensure the accuracy, what we should do? Errors are identified and located. Many business enterprises have shifted. Already I have told you, manual accounting to the computerized based accounting. Yet, errors in the accounting are unavoidable. It is unavoidable. Even though in the computerized accounting, who is going to operate the computer? Man is going to, human being is going to operate the computer. For example, 27,000. The money, the amount is 27,000. He may enter the amount as a 2,700. There is a chance. There is a chance by oversight he can see accountant is having too many work. Because of pressurization of work, he can enter wrongly. There is a possibility. So, yet the errors are not unavoidable. So, hence errors have to be located and rectified to find out what? Find out the real profit of the position. Whether it is a profit or the concern is running in loss. And we know the financial position of the concern. What is the financial position? Where it is available, where we can see assets and liabilities, where we can see the assets and liabilities, only in the balance sheet. So different periods we are framing the balance sheet. Usually at the end of the financial year we will prepare the balance sheet, isn't it? So for that reason we are studying this chapter. The main purpose of studying this chapter is to rectify the errors and then identify the errors and then rectify the errors. Whatever error we have committed while posting the journal entry, lot of stages want to come, isn't it? Stage by stage we are posting to the entry, isn't it? So each and every stage the error is quite natural. So what are all the errors is coming in each and every stage and how to rectify that, we are going to learn one by one. Now let us move on to the meaning of errors. What does mean by rectification of errors? That is, rectification of errors means, what does mean by error? Errors means recording, classifying and summarizing. What they are going to summarize? The accounting transaction wrongly, or which transaction? Wrong transaction, or omission to record. Whether what are all the transactions they are going to concentrate? Wrong transaction and the transaction which is omitted to record them by a clerk or an accountant unintentionally. It is not the intention to do. Unintentionally, by oversight, he can do the mistake. This is called rectification of errors. The meaning of the word error. Error means what? Once again, I will tell you. Recording or classifying or summarizing, what they are going to do? Accounting transaction. What they are going to use? Accounting transaction wrongly or omission to record them by a clerk or an accountant unintentionally. Then let us move on to the different stages of accounting. What are all the stages we have come across? See, first stage is at the stage of journalizing, at the stage of ledger posting, at the stage of trial balance. So each and every stage, what are all the errors can commit? What is the possibilities to do the error? So one by one let us see. We have seen the meanings, isn't it? So at the stage of journalizing, what are all the errors is possible? Error of omission, error of commission, error of principle. So it is very, very easy. Error of omission means we have omitted to enter the transaction. So what is mean the error of omission? That is the failure of the accountant to record a transaction or an item in the books of account. It is known as error of omission. commission means what? The accountant forgot to enter the transaction. That is called error of omission. So error of commission means incorrectly recorded. What does mean by error of commission? When the transaction is incorrectly recorded, that is known as error of commission. So it is usually, when it will occur, it is due to the concentration and carelessness of the accountant. This will happen. Then error of principle, mistakes committed in the application. Even the main principle itself they can change. For example, they will change the purchases into sales, purchase of assets into purchase of goods. So these are all, see, purchase of assets. Purchase of assets means what? In the journal proper only you want to enter the entry. So they will treat it as a purchase of goods. So that is a error of principle. Purchase of assets is treated as a purchase of goods. So main principle itself, there is an error. Then at the stage of posting, journalizing stage, these are all the errors we can commit. At the stage of posting, error of omission. There are two types of error of omissions. The error of omissions can be subdivided into two. One is a partial omission, another one is a complete omission. See, partial omission means what? See, when the accountant has failed to record a part of the transaction. See, for example, purchases are, you have purchased through cash means purchases accounts alone he can record. He forgot to write the entry in the cash account, isn't it? So that is called the partial omission. He has recorded in the purchases book, but he forgot to record in the cash book means that is a partial omission. Complete omission means the same purchases account and also the cash account he forgot to enter the transaction. It is called complete omission. So error of commission. So in that case, posting to wrong account. Purchases can be treated as a sales or purchases can be treated as a purchase returns. So he can wrongly enter into the posting into the some other wrong account. And then posting of wrong amount. Sales made to Ravi rupees 20,000. Instead of 20,000, accountant is going to write Ravi account. In that Ravi account, see what is the entry for the sales? Ravi account data, because it is a credit sales. Ravi account data to sales, isn't it? So in that Ravi account, two sales, that side is correct side, but amount is wrong. So posting of wrong amount only, they say. In the correct side, it is implied. Then posting to wrong side. See, purchased goods for rupees 4,000 rupees by cash. We have purchased 4,000 rupees by cash. What is the journal entry? Purchases account data to cash account. In that purchases account, cash account will be debit. Whereas wrongly he has written in the credit side. So posting to wrong side. So these are all the possibilities the errors will happen. It is quite natural. Unintentionally the error must happen. We cannot avoid. So at the stage of balancing, at the stage of internal balance, and what is the classification of errors, then what is meant by error of we have seen that error of omission means what? Failure to record the transaction. Completely forgot. So error of commission means incorrectly he has recorded, but it is incorrect. Then error of principle means purchases are first, assets can be treated as a purchase of goods. Then simple purchases can be treated as a sales, or sales can be treated as a purchases. These are all error of principle. The application itself they have made the mistake. Then at the stage of posting, there are two types of error. Error of omission, this can be classified into two: partial omission and complete omission. Partial omission means purchases, we are doing the purchases means purchases book alone we have written, enter the transaction, posting journal also, ledger also, but forgot to enter in the cash book. So that is called partial. One entry, debit entry alone completed, credit entry forgot. Otherwise credit entry alone completed, debit entry forgot. So this is a partial omission. Complete omission, both debit and credit entry completely omitted, forgot to enter the transaction.
Then error of commission. What is mean by error of commission? Already I have explained you, when the transaction is incorrectly recorded, it is known as error of commission. So it is how it is happen, incorrect record, what are all the possibilities? Posting to wrong account, posting of wrong amount, and posting to wrong side. These are all the possibilities we can do. How? Because of accountant carelessness, concentration, lack of concentration and carelessness of the accountant, these are all the errors will be happening in the accounts. It is unavoidable. Let us move on to the other stage of balancing. Posting error of commission we have seen. So at the stage of journalizing we have completed, at the stage of posting we have completed, and what is the stage we have seen? Let us pre-call one by one, journal, ledger, then after that we have balance the ledger. So if you want to know the opening balance and closing balance, so at the stage of balancing, what are all the errors will come in? Let us see. Let us move on to the next error at the stage of balancing. At the stage of balancing, the error can be this type of following errors may occur. What are all the type? Wrong totaling of account. Wrong totaling, or we call it as wrong casting. Casting means totaling. And also wrong balancing of account. First one, let us see about wrong totaling of account. Page wise we are totaling, isn't it? Page number 1, 2, 3, LF number, ledger folio number we are writing, isn't it? So while taking the total number of page number, sales here we have written, the rupees is 5765. While carry forward to the next page, the accountant was wrongly entered as a page number 16 only he is going to write. So while carry forward 5675. So how much rupees he has written or written wrongly? 5765. Instead of 5765, he has written 5675. So under casting of totaling. So then this is the possibility. This is called wrong totaling of account. Then wrong balance. While totaling itself, see total he is writing. First page he is going to write the total, isn't it? Each and every sales page he is going to write the total. And the particular page total he wants to take carry forward to the next page. So on that stage he has committed this kind of mistake. Then wrong balancing. At the stage of posting, what is the wrong opening balance and closing balance want to write, isn't it? Opening balance, then only he has to post the entry. So in this case, wrongly he has written the opening balance and the closing balance. That is also the possibility. So sometimes at the time of balancing in ledger account, the wrong balance may be written. What are all the possibilities arising of this? Is arising out of balancing of an account. Wrong balance. Wrong balance means what? Because of opening balance also we can write wrongly, and we can take over to the next page to another page. Then we have to balance the credit sales and the cash sales. While balancing the credit sales and cash sales, we can wrongly return. There is a possibility. So let us, these are all the possibilities at the stage of balancing. Then at the stage of preparing trial balance, there are a lot of errors are there. And also in error of commission also, there is lot of possibilities are there. Error of commission, there are lot of possibilities. I will give you a gist of the possibilities. I will give you a gist. From that gist, we are going to learn elaborately in this chapter. What is the gist? That is, in this error of commission, what is mean by error of commission? You have seen, isn't it? So this is an error due to wrong recording, wrong posting, then wrong casting, wrong balancing, wrong carry forward. That is called error of commission. So this can be classified into error of recording. Error of recording and also posting. And also it is called as a Oh, stay, isn't it? So, error of recording, what are all the possibilities? What are the errors will occur? The error arises when a transaction is wrongly recorded in the books of original entry. For example, goods purchased ₹5,000, purchased on credit from Digi. It is not recorded in the books for rupees. It is recorded. We have purchased from Digi for rupees. Purchases account. We have to record ₹5,000 only. So it is wrongly recorded as a ₹5,500. So these are all the possibilities of error of recording. So purchases on credit from Digi, isn't it? So it is recorded in the books of Digi ₹5,500. So this error does not affect the trial balance, because this error of recording is not affect the trial balance. Then error of posting. Let us see error of posting. Lot of possibilities are there.